It's not unlike the sound of the B-24 Liberators that were built here at Willow Run Airport. One every 56 minutes to the tune of over 8,600. But the engines, the dedications, the crews, the mission,
taxi. Taxi out, hold short of runway 5 left. About another 5 minutes. Still 6-3, cross runway 5 left, taxi all the way. We have got taxiway, hold short of runway 23 right.
Okay, we're closing 05 left, fly as we go out and holding short to the sea line, jumping up to 063.
successful 25 missions without getting shot down. But in certain cases, the losses were staggering on the daylight raids that the United States Army Air Force conducted on German targets in Europe.
They got there, but they didn't have any fire protection. They had no way of having protection from German fire craft.
Yeah, they were on the way out. They would have protection against the Luftwaffe, but as they got closer to the targets, then the anti-aircraft fire, the flak, was an issue, and those were shells that were exploded at the altitude at which these
are down to the end, right, sir. We're going to do the same thing we did this morning, all the way around the gob.
So they had to have a sight that worked very accurately from that altitude so that he and his wingman will be able to complete their formation flight or maneuver safely. It is the job of the wingman not to look where the ground is, where the sky is, where they're going, but that wing pilot has a focus specifically on a couple of spots on the lead aircraft, and then uses the control yoke for pitch and roll and the throttles for position, and it's all moving all the time to maintain a good position on another aircraft. It's a very challenging skill.
The first sketch on those engines, is that how the formation flying at night, the bridge and the Lancaster bombers, were they looking at the hot engine exhaust to see where the aircraft was so they could spot themselves, or were there lights on the tails of those things?
Good question. I don't know the answer to that. I do not know. That's a great question.
I wonder how they did it at night.
Oh, that's interesting.
I'll tell you what we do sometimes forget too, is how they lost their lives, but how they were captured by the Germans and stayed the rest of the war.
Indeed, there were hundreds, thousands. In that August 10th mission I was talking about, they were going to the ball bearing factories at Schweinfurt. And in that raid of the 251 bombers that participated, 60. They were the folks who kept things going at home to provide the munitions, the equipment, and the weaponry so that we could successfully fight against the Japanese and the Japanese and the Germans and the Italians.
This airport wasn't here in the 30s. It was called Willow Creek here, right? It's farmland. And then in the late 30s, Henry Ford came along. He was going to use this for automotive research. And then they built an airport. And of course, the United States government came to him and said, we should build some bombers. Build B-24s. Right. Over there.
And it became known initially as Ford's Folly. Now, the B-24 Liberator was the biggest at the time. And over the course of World War II, the second largest heavy bomber that the United States Army Air Force had. And it had 1,225,000 parts.
No.
And Henry Ford said, I can turn out one an hour. And they laughed at him. And it turned out, eventually, they produced
before he lands.
Of the 18,000 bombers. And it turned out one every 56 minutes. Prowler finally got old, and so the Navy said.